Hey, it's Mel from Melvin Travel at Busch Gardens on a beautiful day today. Nice and sunny. Well, today's the second day of the Mardi Gras celebration here at Busch Gardens. We're going to check out some of the sights, the food, the fun, and all that other stuff. So, come along. Here's the Big Ben Tower as we enter. Uh-oh, train is right behind us. We'll be hopping on that later, I think. But first, we're going to go over to France. We're going to go check out some beignets and some other food on that side. Animals. Here's a nice friendly one. I think he wants me to rub him.
That's my beautiful thing, because he's over there doing that
too. Yeah. Huh. They have Clydesdales here. So, if you ever want to see some Clydesdales in Virginia, here they are. They are beautiful animals. Busch Gardens is considered to be one of the most beautiful parks in the U.S. and it even got honored. As you can see, it's real wooded, but I tell you, when the trees bloom, this place is just nothing but greenery. Okay, and here's a ride that I once said I would never get on. And you know what? I still will never get on it. To enter into Ireland. Okay, let's start the day off right by going to Grogan's and have a little something to drink. Okay, it's worth the wait. Abbey Stone Theater, well, they're having shows there. But now we're going to go past Castle O'Sullivan and going into France. On our way to France, stop by the Eagle Ridge to look at the bald eagles. They are huge and fantastic. I'm hoping I can get another shot of them. This doesn't really give you the how big these things are.
He's coming out to see what's going on. It's a younger one, or a female, maybe.
Because they have different heads.
A little bit inquisitive about it. The whole stuff is not fully trusted yet. So right now I'm working on just feeding him from near the box, interacting with the box, so that he can get used to it. Because owls are cavity nesters, and they do like to go inside enclosed spaces. Okay, good boy. Okay, Denali. We haven't tried it, but they have gotten it. Denali? Anoki? They're free.
I forget that this is more than just a theme park. This is also a park filled with zoological wonders. We've got the aviary, we've got a wolf area. So there's a lot of places. We've seen the sheep and the horses. I'm sorry, the Clyde. Okay, welcome to France. Let's try some French stuff. Watch out for the train tracks. Everything is really decorated in festive Mardi Gras type colors. And here in France, the fleur. Okay, here we are at Cafe Lulu Beignets, and we have beignets of your choice: caramel, chocolate, or raspberry drizzle. I think I'm gonna have to have one, and maybe a passion fruit hurricane in the spirit of things. We're getting closer to the line. Almost time. My lips are wet with anticipation. Okay, I'm about to have my beignet after waiting 35 minutes for it. So it better be good. Finally a nice quiet place. The beignet was great. Soft, pillowy. I love the raspberry dressing. This is good. I need to figure out what it's going to be in comparison with the beignet at Universal. Okay, there's more to come. It took 30 minutes to get that beignet, and I've got a free sample. Well, I got a sampler card, which is $44. So that was only one. I need to sample some more. So here we go. Some people enjoying the street performers out here. Let's see what we've got here. We've got crawfish boil, blackened chicken for $8, and Mardi Gras corn. Once again, the rum runner and draft beer looks pretty good right now. Okay, well, this is our blackened chicken sample. Actually, it's a little bit more than I expected. So it's spicy, but it got some pepper, green pepper, red pepper. It looks great, and it tastes great. Wow, well, the chicken was really good. It was moist, tender. The flavor was great. So now it's on to the next place. Okay, we're on our way to Germany now. Going past the Flume, so we'll see what we have on this side in terms of treats. King of cakes. We're gonna get funnel cake, beignets, and cheesecake. Okay, now here's my bananas Foster. Gotta have some water with this, but it didn't take too long to get it. I'm looking forward to see what it tastes like. So it's getting a little bit cooler now that the sun is going down. But fortunately, they have these fire pits around the park, which kind of helps to warm you up after drinking all that cold beer and hurricanes. Okay, now we're entering Germany. The first thing we see is the Bayou Bar. So Have to do a sample there. A DJ at Fest House. Not your traditional jazz. Okay, let's see if I can get a Cajun Bloody Mary. Another real long line. Well, here it comes. Here it comes. Busch Gardens Dark Oyster. Launch in 2023.
It's launching in the spring.
That sounds like a perfect launch, but I don't care.
So this looks like it's going to be an interesting coaster. Here's the outside. It looks like they have a lot more work to do, but it's supposed to be happening this summer. This is part of the beauty of Busch Gardens, with the lush landscapes, the call of nature, and it's even more beautiful when everything turns green. So it's time to leave now. It's just a part of what they do for their celebration of Mardi Gras, and I think I'll probably be back again just to see if there's more things open, because there was only one roller coaster working today. All right, I'll catch you all on the flip side.
Welcome to Busch Gardens Williamsburg.